I should say that most of my paying clients come from YouTube.
Today we're going to talk about something that is going to interest you a lot. We're going to talk about how to build a business around YouTube. And with me here is Ismael Lamptey. Ismael, welcome to the channel once again.
Thank you.
I believe if you've watched the other video, which a link will be up there and in the description, you've gotten to know that we shared a couple of tips on freelancing as to how to start up with a freelance in Ghana. And today we are talking about building a business around YouTube. So Ismael, the big question is, how do you use YouTube to build a business?
So YouTube is a big space. YouTube allows you to create videos, put it out there for people to check it out.
Okay.
It is very important for you to try as much as not to just look at the fun aspect of maybe doing whatever you love doing best, putting out there, but also trying your possible best to build a business out of YouTube.
Okay.
And how can you do that? So one of the things you can do with YouTube is you put valuable information over there.
Sure.
So because we happen to be in the design space, what I do is I make video tutorials. Now through my tutorials, it has helped me build trust on the internet.
Sure.
How has that been possible? So this is what happens. People checked out or people have a problem. Just like you might have a problem, you jump onto Google, how do I do this, blah blah blah, or you jump onto YouTube, how do I do this? So once you build something towards what people are looking at or what people are searching for, they get to identify whatever you are doing. They get to learn from you.
Okay.
Then they are able to trust you, because it won't just be one video, it will be a couple of videos that they get to see from you. So once they are able to trust you, then it hasn't become difficult for them to come to you to bring you jobs or even to request for more information from you. So that's one of the ways that you can use YouTube to, you know, help you building trust, because trust is very important.
Very important.
I don't trust you, I can't give you money for you to do anything.
Exactly.
For me. And looking at somebody staying somewhere in, let's say, USA, they're somewhere here in Ghana, the person has chance on your channel, seen your content, it's helped them a lot, then they probably would want more. So then they can't, you know, they don't mind, you know, hiring you to do something for them. So that's one of the things that has helped me a lot.
Okay, so actually YouTube is the second largest search engine that is after Google. So if you put content out there, for instance, we are in the design space, so Ismael is putting out how to design websites, I'm putting out how to make cartoons and flyers and all those stuff. The moment people get to see it and realize you are good at it, they don't mind coming to you, just like Ismael said. So YouTube is a very big space for you to put your content out there. Okay, so Ismael, you've been on YouTube for how long?
So I've been doing YouTube for about 3 years or more. Yeah.
Okay. And have you sort of received any payments from YouTube?
I should say that most of my paying clients come from YouTube. Somewhere last week, I had a client, just a new client, I've never met him before.
Mm-hmm.
Apparently he was encountering some challenges.
Okay.
He jumped onto YouTube, he searched for something, I happened to show up as part of the resource, or my video happened to show up.
Okay.
He got, you know, valuable information from in there, then straight away he jumped onto my website. So that means I have a website, you don't necessarily need a website. And then he saw a lot of more information over there, then he decided, you know what, let me just send him a message through his contact form. He sent me a message, I called him, we started, you know, discussing a project he wanted me to work on for him. And that was one way I just landed a client just by YouTube. I hope you get it.
Yes.
Yeah.
Sure. So I want to know if you sort of received anything like a payment from YouTube, from AdSense or something like that.
Okay. So my goal with YouTube hasn't necessarily been like monetize my channel.
But then we just want to know if...
I think I have. That was somewhere, about 2 years ago, 2 years or a year ago. I think 2 years ago, when I joined the AdSense program, but I realized the money I got from AdSense wasn't really that much.
Sure.
Because I don't know. I'm sure there are ways by which you can get more money from YouTube and the rest.
Okay.
But that hasn't really been my interest. I'm looking at being able to get clients from YouTube. So that's what I basically do.
All right. So the key point here is that you don't really have to wait to monetize your YouTube before you start making money. Actually, you're going to talk about another point, which is affiliate marketing. So basically, affiliate marketing is referring people to other people's sites like Amazon and Jumia, all these sites. You can basically refer people out there. You have a lot of people on your Instagram, your Facebook, your LinkedIn, and all those stuff. You can utilize them. Even nowadays, WhatsApp is becoming a very big place to get people. So people are watching your status. You just have to get the link and then you put it over there and you refer people. What do you have to say about
Part of affiliate marketing, I have actually been in a couple of affiliate marketing. So like the domain I use, I have an affiliate program with them whereby I recommend people to purchase domains and I earn something from it.
Okay.
A couple of softwares I use the same way. A couple of gears I use the same way. So then at the end of the day, you end up getting bits and pieces from almost everywhere and then it helps you with whatever you're doing. As much as you are doing affiliate marketing, you shouldn't jump onto almost everything. You shouldn't mislead people. It is very important for you to recommend products you believe in, recommend services you have personally tried. So don't just, because you're looking at gaining money, so you just go out there, just put anything out there for people to, you know, check it out. At the end of the day, if it doesn't help them, it comes back to affect you. So these are some of the things you probably have to bear in mind if you are going about affiliate marketing.
All right, so number three, we have to talk about the YouTube AdSense. In as much as we are saying that you shouldn't focus solely on YouTube AdSense, it still add up. Say if you are making like $100 to $200 from YouTube AdSense, that is money. So you have to be making the money.
Yes.
In as much as you are looking at all these other ways of gaining money from YouTube, you have to also focus on your content and then create better valuable content that will keep people watching, that will increase your time, watch time and everything, views, so that you gain money also out of AdSense.
That's a very important point over there, in a sense that a couple of people actually have their YouTube as their business. They wake up, they do videos and the rest, like full-time YouTube, and they're making money out of it. Now how they are making money has to do with the kind of content they are creating, and those kind of content has to be something that provides valuable information that people definitely would want to be checking out. And then also people have some of the subscribers sponsoring or supporting whatever you are doing. Exactly. So those are some of the ways by which you get to earn something through YouTube as part of AdSense.
All right. So that brings us to Patreon and other stuffs like GoFundMe.
Yeah.
A couple of people uses GoFundMe, PayPal and Patreon. So if you are creating something like a tutorial, you don't necessarily, like, you don't gain a lot from making tutorials. Unlike other people in the lifestyle and the other niches, they make a lot of money. Unlike those of us who are into the tutorial space. So tutorials, you have a lot also goes into it.
Yeah.
So you can ask for your subscribers to be patrons or sponsor you through PayPal or GoFundMe. So that way also you can build something. That is not really a business, but then you are providing value. So people sponsoring you for providing value isn't that a big deal, I think.
Yeah, so like Patreon, he's saying, so Patreon basically helps, you know, you create some kind of community which they help or support whatever you are doing because they believe in what you are doing, or they found a lot of valuable information from whatever you do, so they don't mind like donating. It's more or less like donating to you or supporting whatever you are doing. So that's what Patreon basically help you with. And then you have GoFundMe as well, and you can also receive payments with PayPal and the rest, and even your mobile money.
Every one of them makes money. All right, so wrapping up the video, we just want to inform you that irrespective of the niche that you are into, entertainment, lifestyle, celebrity, graphic design, web design, tech, every space that you are, you can basically create something around YouTube. YouTube is a very big space that you can utilize it, especially in this modern area. So if you are looking at, you are sitting out there and thinking of starting up something, you can use your phone. You don't really need, that one is very important.
Very
you don't really need expensive gadgets.
You can start by using your phone.
You can start over with everything that you are having and then you create something around YouTube. Don't forget also that it is not always about AdSense. You have a lot of things that we've discussed that you can use in making money. So Ismael, any final words before we
so at the end of the day, try as much as possible to produce or provide valuable content that people are going to fall in love with, that wouldn't they wouldn't mind supporting you through Patreon or, you know, donating to whatever you do. And yeah, at the end of the day, you realize you've gained a lot of people following you based on what you do. So you should do what you believe in, and you should, when you're looking at recommending products and services, they should be services or products you personally have tried or you believe in, so I don't mislead anyone. Just go out there, start creating something.
All right, so creating something out there, something that is valuable, not just because you want to create something around YouTube, you just head over to YouTube and start posting anything. Create something that is valuable, that is going to interest people so that they can contact you for any other thing. Much more of this will be coming up on the channel very soon. And don't forget also to head over to Ismael's channel. A link will be in the description. Head over to show some love. He has some amazing content that he can gain much value from it. So till the next video, see you guys again.